But what the brain brings from the past? Brings very bad memories sometimes.
Yeah, traumas.
And you have to re-experience what the brain brings to us.
Yeah.
And you live from the past, you live now in misery. What the heck?
Yeah.
This is not a reason. And the author is giving you simple techniques how to live now. One of the important principles to live now, it's forgiveness. No judgment. We always judge. The brain has tendency to judge, to qualify, to discriminate, to, to persecute some people, to crucify them. We have so many people, they own us, but we forget what we own others. For example, what I can say about this brain, we think that we're the center of the universe.
Yeah.
And we do not realize that we are part of this earth and this heaven. And actually, we're a combination between the earth and the heaven, the both energy. And how to explain to you, two Buddhist monks, they work together. And the oldest Buddhist monk was shaving his head because they shave and they have ponytail here. And the young Buddhist monk was not experienced yet of the technique as it is, except the things they are in this moment. And also, most of us, we don't realize how rich we are. We all like to possess a lot of items, a lot of junk, and I'm a good example. For example, I'm buying a lot of books. And my room become crowded with books. And this really take my energy. The greatest scientist, the greatest saint, they live very simple life. For example, they went to visit a man who worked very hard and who has very simple way of life. And he was washing his shirt. And they asked him, people are coming from the street to see you. Are you going to dress? He said, just let me finish. Squeeze the water from my shirt that I can have shirt on my back, you know. Just like to give you a simple example that we have so many things that we don't need and they preoccupy this brain and make it crazy.
Yeah.
And the best bet, every day if you can throw 10 items from your house and give to some poor people, this is the best bet. But to live now, not too many people realize how to live now. We live now, for example, if we drive motorcycle in the freeway very quick, very fast, because we have to keep with the traffic and we can get killed if we are not living now. Also, we experience living now when we have orgasm. This is also the time when we experience now.
Oh, okay.
But we have the biggest happiness will be if we learn to live most of the time and to stop even for a few seconds to live now.
Huh?
For example, when you work for an hour, you don't have to close your eye, sit like the Buddhist, like the grand saint in meditation and expect enlightenment or peace. No, you can do your cooking. You can do something and you still can practice meditation of now. How? The best way to concentrate is to listen your breathing. It's innate. It's inside of you. If you close your eye and live on the floor, for example, and you avoid the brain, follow the brain. The brain will come with different ideas. With different thoughts about the future, the past, about the hatred of the neighbor, about some bullshit, you know. But let this go through you. Concentrate on the breathing. But do not force yourself to breathe. Be a silent observer, witness. Listen to your breathing. Don't force yourself. You can concentrate also on the candle. But you have to find candle. You have to find a quiet
room. Candle.
But you always have your chest. You have breathing and you have to sustain in life in order to take oxygen and to inhale and exhale. How you do this? Just for 5 minutes? The best bet is 20 minutes. But for 5 minutes, lay down and just listen your breathing. If you can reach this point, you are now. And now will bring you all the happiness. It's innate. We usually blame girlfriend, father, mother, relatives for ours. Yeah. In happiness or ours, that feeling. But we do not realize that all the happiness the universe put inside of us, yeah, it's innate.
Yeah.
It's given to us.
Yeah.
And it's not too simple to reach this technique. You have to be very perseverant and you have to spend time. You always have time. During the day when you work hard for hour or two, break it. Close your eye. And listen your breathing.
Sorry, see, I have to go.
Okay, Leighton, thank you.
I have to help my wife do some things.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Leighton. I hope to see you next time. I hope to talk to you on the phone, please. Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye. You did an honor for joining me. Thank you. Everybody say goodbye to Leighton, please.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Leighton.
Goodbye,
Leighton. Please continue.
Okay. Zik, he met with my friend George Pavlov. He's a clinical psychologist. You asked me who I am. I was doctor here, chiropractor for many years, but George has a library for 150,000 books, bigger than, three times bigger than LA library.
Wow.
And these books, I have the key. But we have all, most of the books, he managed to put them electronically. And some of them, they're available on the internet, but he's not giving them too easy, but if somebody show a dedication that he would like to learn some of the books, he's ready to step on the phone, or we can send him a copy of the electronic book, and he can talk with us. Before we send this, we take appointments, and George will talk them individually to feel that the person can qualify, actually, because he doesn't want to give his book just of somebody who would like to possess his book. This book is not his. He just like to see, for example, I have a lady friend, Victoria. George tried to tell her a little bit about awakening, uh-huh, of the Ida wisdom.
Look at the camera, look at the camera. Here.
But I'm a little tired. But she has a glass, her brain is full. She cannot accept anything
Victoria?
New.
Victoria?
No, I'm not talking about names. And George, he gave up. He said, don't put her on the phone anymore. She is so, so knowledgeable. And whenever I say, her glass is full of water. She has to empty her glass in order to accept the new knowledge.
Yeah.
And if somebody is ready, I will let him talk with George. Thank you for the interview. And nice to talk with you.
It was
such
an honor to have you.
I'm little
in sanctuary, in this meeting on sanctuary. Honor to have you. It was a blessing. There's so much wisdom. I think that's the basic truth, like the Todor, that if we just if we have just that one goal, is that if we can just pay attention to our breathing for 5 minutes, I think, and stop the chatter in our heads. For 5 minutes, I think that one goal, it doesn't seem like it. I have come to the same conclusion, Toto, all of you, that having gone through all the varieties of cults and religions and philosophies and modalities, that's the same conclusion, is just make it your goal. You have all the other things. You want to make a living. You want to have a relationship. But that the one important thing, just pay attention to your breathing 5 minutes a day.
I forget to tell you something important. Even the outer belief of the time of death, if we are living now and we're awakened for this technique, this will help us to transfer the consciousness from this life to the new life.
Okay. We'll cross that bridge when we get there. I'll think about dying when I die, because I think I have a while to go. I actually don't want to die. I think I actually believe I can go on and on. I don't believe in dying. I don't think just because my age goes up, I'm going to grow old and die. It's a belief that everybody has, and that's why it's the way it is. I actually don't believe I'm going to grow old and die, although I'm got a little gray hair already. So that's it.
I disagree with Zig because he go from the age. No, we live every day. It's our last day.
Oh, okay.
We may die whenever we decide, but sometimes we die unexpectedly.
Okay.
And even if we die without notice, we do not expect some of the people, they expect the death, and they know when they're going to die in the bed. But I'm talking even unexpectedly, if you learn this technique, you'll be well off for the next rebirth or whenever. You can move everything, because when we die, we don't cannot take even one penny with us, you know.
Yeah, but we do take.
And the worst things, most of them, when we die, our agenda, our efforts, they perish. Yeah. Nothing left. We vanish. But let me finish.
Yeah.
But when you learn this technique, you can move your agenda, what you're doing right now and like to achieve, from this life to the next.
Exactly.
One, and you can carry on.
Exactly. That's a very fundamental truth, the conclusion that I've come to also, that everybody knows you're not going to take your wealth with you when your body dies and you go on to the next incarnation. You do take your soul with you. And this is the most fundamental truth that I have learned with my time studying with Janet Richmond. The work I do on the soul, purifying my soul from all the traumas and negative experiences, all the negativity, all the false beliefs that my soul has accumulated from the countless lifetimes until now, that once I clear away all of that negativity, all of the skull scrambles, all of the imprints from my previous lifetimes, I remove the obstacles from it, stop standing in my own way, I am so much freer. And then, of course, if I possibly die and go to the next life, I will be taking to my next life a pure and perfect soul, which will then be, then that would mean that my life would be so much more rewarding.